Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for being online to discuss material science, engineering, and technology. I think especially for those experts from Europe at this early morning. Many thanks to the previous nice talks given by Professor Kobayashi and Professor Mar. I think I will go through my presentation as quickly as I can to save some time. My name is Xiaofei Sun from Xi’an Jiaotong University. It's my great honor to share some of our work on phosphate cathodes and oxide anodes for rechargeable lithium and sodium batteries today. First, I would like to introduce some of our research directions in our group. We explore key materials and develop various devices for advanced energy storage and conversion applications, such as lithium batteries, sodium batteries, and supercapacitors. Recently, we have also launched several projects on battery manufacturing technologies. For example, laser-aided processing and the intelligent manufacturing to get good quality battery cells. As indicated by my presentation title, today I would focus on the cathode and anode active materials for rechargeable lithium or sodium batteries. Especially those phosphate cathode materials and oxide anode materials. I think the structure and performance relationships are emphasized in my presentation. First, I will give a brief introduction on the battery background shortly. Rechargeable batteries, including lithium batteries and sodium batteries, are widely used in high efficiency energy storage fields, such as portable electronics, electric vehicles, smart grids, money, and military applications here. High energy density and high power density are usually most required for practical application of rechargeable batteries. Of course, safety, lifespan, and cost are also important parameters. Take lithium-ion battery as an example. The typical device structure is composed of here cathode, anode, electrolyte, even separator, and the cabinet. Alkaline as earth metal ions, such as lithium ions, are inserted or extracted in the electrode materials during charging and discharging, like a rocking chair mechanism. As the reservoirs for lithium ions, electrode materials play a key role on the electrode performance of lithium batteries. According to the crystal structure, current cathode materials could be divided into three categories, namely lead oxides, for example, lithium cobalt dioxide, and a series of ternary oxides, spinel lithium manganese oxides, and the high voltage derivatives, polyanion compounds. For example, lithium iron phosphate. These are the structures, crystal structure of the typical cathode materials. There are also three kinds of anode materials according to lithium storage mechanisms, namely insertion reaction based for example, a graphite, and also alloy-based anode materials such as silicon, tin, and the last one, conversion reaction-based anodes. For example, manganese oxide. These are the typical structures. One needs to note that a recent lithium metal anode is now intensively reinvestigated in order to solve its interface stability with the electrolytes so as to significantly improve the energy density of lithium batteries. In consideration of designing good electrode materials, high capacities with high potentials are preferred for cathode materials, which should be here, and also well, high capacities with low potentials are preferred for anode here within the safe potential window of the electrolytes. Rechargeable sodium batteries have similar device structure and materials requirements as lithium batteries. The cathode and anode materials are the key components because they are sodium carriers for energy storage. Actually, we have designed, synthesized, and modified a variety of energy materials for lithium and sodium batteries, including cathode and anode materials in the last decade. Today, I would like to introduce some of our research work on phosphate cathode and oxide anode materials. For current commercial lithium ion phosphate cathode, we did some fundamental study to understand the mystery of performance degradation in large particle lithium ion phosphate, aiming to obtain high energy and high density at the same time. So first, we prepared ultra-large micro-sized lithium ion phosphate through an optimal hydrothermal method. After careful investigation by synchrotron X-ray diffraction and Raman spectroscopy, anti-slide defects and surface iron oxide are observed in the ultra-large micro-sized lithium iron phosphates. Lithium was partially extracted from lithium iron phosphate by chemical distillation to study the structure of lithium iron phosphate in different states of charge. Meanwhile, we noticed that chemical distillation in organic solvents here is more reliable to keep the structure and morphology integrity comparing with chemical distillation in aqueous solvents here in these two pictures. And the mechanism is explained here in this scheme. Post-annealing was then employed on large particle lithium ion phosphates with different lithium contents, aiming to see the structure performance relationship. With the help of in situ synchrotron X-ray diffraction, clear two-phase reaction during charge and discharge is observed during charging, discharging. And the sluggish electrochemical kinetics is ascribed to the inferior battery performance of large particle lithium ion phosphate here by these electrochemical tests. Based on above findings, we proposed some principles for designing high performance large particle lithium ion phosphate cathode materials. The large secondary particles are better homogeneously stacked by thin diamond shaped primary particles to form a mesoporous structure. And the electrochemical performance could be further improved combining soft coating, bulk doping, as widely used in literature. In addition, iron excess and should be carefully controlled, and non-storage should be remembered to avoid the influence of water and oxygen. The idea actually has been realized by Zhang, et cetera, and the practical morphology of this designing looks like this, stacked together to form spheric morphology. In the next part, we are going to optimize the overall electrochemical performance of lithium vanadium fluorophosphate as a novel high safety, high energy cathode material for rechargeable lithium batteries. Similar to olivine lithium iron phosphate, triclinic lithium vanadium fluorophosphate is also constituted of PO4, tetrahydro, and transition metal centered octahydro. Its specific energy actually is almost 14% higher than lithium iron phosphate due to the mildly higher charge discharge voltage plateaus at around 4.2 volts versus lithium. Moreover, lithium vanadium fluorophosphate have been proved possessing the best thermal stability among all the cathode materials so far, even much better than lithium iron phosphate. So the question actually is the low electronic conductivity and lithium diffusivity that severely constrain its performance and practical application. So we first adopted a variety of effective atomic doping, such as chromium doping on lithium site and titanium doping on vanadium site to improve the electric conductivity as well as the battery performance to a certain degree. And we also used multi-cation doping on both lithium site and vanadium site to get the overwhelmingly improved battery performance. On the other hand, composite formation such as lithium vanadium fluorophosphate with lithium vanadium phosphate, lithium iron phosphate, carbon nanotubes here, and also reduced graphene oxide was also applied to get improved battery performance. These methods actually are beneficial to get relatively enhanced performance, but the complicated synthesis process is not that favorable. Instead, we developed a high-performance composite by simply tuning the defects during traditional carbon thermal reduction method, synthesis method. After rationally tuning the lithium occupation, the vacancy, vanadium vacancies, and the manganese doping, the battery performance is tremendously improved here. The specific discharge capacity is slowly decayed from 126 milliampere hour per gram to almost 140 after 1,000 cycles at 1C rate, corresponding to a capacity retention of 90%, which means only 0.01% of the capacity is lost per cycle. The electrochemical performance is outstanding and is promising for practical application. More importantly, the synthesis process is simple and is compatible with traditional production line. So this development has been widely recognized by researchers and engineers. ICDD used the part diffraction fail, and our work has been awarded as the best post award. Nobel laureate Alan Heger delivered the certificate to me. It's a great honor, I think. High-performance lithium vanadium fluorophosphate is prepared by understanding the deep structure performance relationship, especially the defect in the crystal structure. And they are now scaling up for medium production. This is a typical charge-discharge curve of massively produced material. It is pretty competitive with high capacity and high voltage. So does the energy density. We can produce such materials in hundreds of kilograms per batch. Inspired by previous lithium iron phosphate and lithium vanadium fluorophosphate, we designed and studied a series of vanadium phosphate-based family materials and all without fluorine for sodium batteries here. As a class of high safety, high voltage, and high capacity cathode materials for sodium batteries, high energy, high power, long lifetime, and wide service temperature could also be achieved by tailoring the chemical structure of sodium vanadium phosphate with fluorine and oxygen. First, we studied the basic Nasican sodium vanadium phosphate and improved the performance by aluminum substitution of vanadium. The best battery performance is obtained when 2% of vanadium is replaced by aluminum. We calculated the unit cell volume shrinkage, and we found that when the doping content is 2%, and the smallest volume change is obtained during charging discharge. And it also shows the highest sodium diffusion rate. We think that might be the two reasons of the performance improvement. Of stoichiometric sodium vanadium phosphate was then designed and prepared. The electrochem performance shows that NVP 1.898, which means with 2% deficient vanadium, has the best battery performance. And the CV test further verifies the reversible activation of 3-4 and 4-5 reaction couples. High resolution TEM with electron diffraction demonstrates the morphology as well as the existence of sodium phosphate in the deficient sample, which might be the reasons of the performance improvement. And we tried to modify the structure stability of sodium vanadium phosphate by fluorine doping. In terms of the good electronegativity of fluorine, as we observed in previous materials, the battery performance is improved actually along with the doping of fluorine, as we can see by these tests. Sodium phosphate and sodium vanadium phosphate are found in highly doped samples, which are also show higher sodium diffusivity here. So the structure integrity after electrochemical cycling was analyzed by high resolution TEM, and fluorine doped materials are proved here having better integrity after cycling. Considering the benefits of fluorine in sodium vanadium phosphate, we tried to prepare sodium vanadium fluorophosphate with high content of fluorine, like its lithium counterparts. We investigated the phase evolution, during solid state synthesis. The structure change was recorded by in situ X-ray. The optimal synthesis parameters of sodium vanadium fluorophosphate is obtained by understanding the products at various temperatures. Furthermore, we clarified that the composition is actually sodium 3 here, not sodium 1, like in lithium vanadium fluorophosphate. The battery performance is further improved by constructing three-dimensional carbonaceous framework of sodium vanadium fluorophosphate in the matrix of carbon and the reduced graphene oxide. The electrochemical performance is much improved by our 3D framework designing. Recently, we are working to further adjust the crystal structure of sodium vanadium fluorophosphate by oxygen to form oxyfluorophosphate, aiming to trigger the vanadium 4-5 couple at high potentials. Actually, we have obtained some primary encouraging results, and the reversible capacity could achieve almost 180 milliampere hours per gram in low charge discharge rates. Although the fast charge discharge ability and long-term cycling stability still need to be improved, but we are confident to get better performance in the near future according to structure engineering. In the last part, I will quickly go through some of our research work on oxide anodes. Oxide anode materials mainly involve conversion reactions with lithium or sodium during charging discharging. They have higher theoretical capacities, but large hysteresis during lithium or sodium insertion or extraction. And the volume changes are also very large. Therefore, scientists are dedicated to solve these problems mainly by nanoelement engineering and composite engineering, and finally to get high performance oxide anode materials. Nanoparticle manganese oxide was prepared and investigated as our study to get to the basic model. And then composite materials such as composite rods of carbon nanotubes with manganese oxides, composite spheres of manganese oxide with carbon nanotubes, and also composite matrix of carbon nanotubes with manganese oxide, carbon, actually are designed and prepared to get high Coulombic efficiency, high specific capacity, fast charge discharge ability, and long-term cycling stability. And biomimetic nanocomposite of ERV-shaped materials are designed and synthesized as well by Sauvo-Sommer method. And the electrochemical performance is noticeably improved here. Except to single metal oxide, multi-metals manganese oxide, such as manganese tin oxide with a bunk-like morphology here, have engineered with graphene in our work. It also shows much better performance comparing to single metal oxide materials. Besides manganese oxide, ferrofluoric oxide were also investigated by forming composite with graphene. The battery performance is improved comparing to biomaterials. Similar strategy was also demonstrated in iron trioxide and is proven somewhat workable. However, speaking of metal oxide, metal oxide anodes as the next generation anode materials for rechargeable batteries, we believe they are still presently still far away from industrial application. Even tin oxide and silicon oxide, in addition to manganese and iron oxide, because there are so many fundamental problems such as low initial Coulombic efficiency, large charge discharge polarization, sluggish lithium or sodium diffusivity, and large volume change during incorporation and extraction of alkaline metals need to be understood and solved first. Then we can practically design high performance materials according to these theories. That's also our lesson, learning from those investigations on the oxide anodes in the previous slides. To summarize, we reported here our work on phosphate cathode materials and oxide anode materials for next generation high performance rechargeable lithium and sodium batteries, especially olivine lithium iron phosphate, triclinic lithium vanadium fluorophosphate, sodium vanadium fluorophosphate, manganese oxide and iron oxide anodes. Our strategy is designing high performance energy materials according to fundamental understanding and the structure performance relationship. We believe phosphate cathodes are near to the market, while oxide anodes are still far away from commercialization until several key problems are solved. In the end, I would share my wish to the green energy materials and systems by citing this colorful battery tree from Professor Taraskin. Lithium battery, sodium battery, and even potassium battery supercapacitors in together are developing rapidly in the last 30 years. And various functional materials used as the cathodes and anodes play a crucial role on the battery performance, even the electrochemical performance, and will no doubt continue to promote the fast development and wide application of rechargeable batteries. My collaborators mainly include colleagues at Xi’an Jiaotong University here in China and co-workers at MIT in US. Actually, Professor Gerbrand Ceder has moved to UC Berkeley. I appreciate all their intelligence, friendliness, and great help. The financial support from NSF, Shaanxi Province, Jiangsu Province, and our partners in industry, like InnoLeisure, are also sincerely acknowledged. That's all my presentation. Thank you very much. You can contact me through my email here. I'm glad to cooperate with you on advanced energy materials and devices in the near future. Thank you very much again. Thank you.